So we all know that British forests don't burn. Oliver Rackham said that they're about as flammable as wet asbestos. But the exception might be the northern boreal forests. The conifers, like this Scots pine, are full of oils and full of resins. So they're actually, the leaves are very flammable. And if you look at northern boreal forests from Scandinavia across to Russia, they do burn on a regular basis. So I'm here at the Abernethy Forest. So did this once burn? Well, here there's a fire scar. You can see that the fire has come along the ground and then burnt up and left this characteristic V-shaped notch. And by looking here, you can age how old the fire was by looking at the tree rings that have happened since it was last burnt. So is there a history of burning? Well, they've done surveys by digging for peat. And if you dig around here and take a core, then of the 31 sites they've done, 8 of them had charcoal remains. 5 of them had 2 layers of charcoal. 1 of them had 3 layers of charcoal. So it seems that there's been a recent history of repeated burning. And there have been surveys in 2 of the bogs around here, and they've shown where there's a much longer record because the bog has retained all that material. And there's repeated burnings having taken place, going back at least 7,500 years. So this could well be natural from lightning. There could still be man-made burns. It could be they're burnt for agriculture. It could be they're burnt accidentally. So the interesting question is how important this is to the management. And there are studies elsewhere which shows that burning has all sorts of consequences. So what tends to happen is that it's very variable. So the burning is less if it's rocky, or if it's shady, or if it's wet, or if it's north-facing. So in reality, rather than there being a single bare area, there'll be a mosaic of different intensities of burning. And what are the consequences of that? Well, it will reduce the ground vegetation and the shrubs. It'll also kill the young trees. So the small trees die, the larger trees tend to persist. And it will vary between species. So birch has very thin bark and is very susceptible to burning, whereas pine has much thicker bark and so much more tolerant of burning. So it could be that these pine forests have a natural history of burning, and that's a key element to their management. And then you can ask what you should do. And obviously burning has a bad name. It's incredibly destructive. The burns we're talking about are ground burns. It's burning the vegetation rather than the crown burns that you see on the television for the dramatic fires. But still, burning can be very destructive. It has a bad reputation, and also it releases a lot of carbon into the atmosphere. So what we do with this information isn't clear, and I don't think many people are talking about considerable burning of forests, but it's an interesting component to their management. And certainly we can't assume, as everyone has done in the past, that British forests never burn.